भाई थोड़ा सा सर नीचे ले लो बस
उसको टच कर
ambitious, adventurous, funny, passionista, and much more. So today, we have with us a talented and a versatile actress sharing her experience and journey. She's one of the most talented and hardworking actresses in the film industry. She has carved a niche for herself from action to romance. She experiments with her roles, which indirectly shows Mr. Rahul Dravid, eminent film director and member of steering committee, and vice chairman ESG, to come upon the stage and present mementos to our esteemed guests.
Audible?
The one in the corner, are you audible? Are
you audible?
Yes. Udhar haath hila rahe hain. You can, right?
Yes.
I'm very loud in life in general.
We know. We love seeing wet and rich and
happy
here.
Thank you.
Much loud here.
Yeah, I'm pleasantly surprised. So many people want to hear me out. Like, thanks, guys. I love it.
Okay, so
for
our lovely audience here, now let's go back to the beginning, okay? So you're a qualified professor. You even took an MBA entrance exam.
Yeah.
And you got it for a corporate job.
Yeah.
So what was the point where you realized this is what I want to do and what I don't want to do? Because, you know, this wasn't your grand plan, right? Being an actress.
Yeah.
And you were never filmy buff.
Yes.
So what happened? What was the kira in you?
I think I'm pretty much a drama queen in my real life, but never took part in any drama. So I've never taken part in any skit, play, nothing of acting department side. In fact, I used to be in the dance society of my college and used to have huge fights with the drama society for the same space to practice. And I used to really laugh at them for like just being so over enthu about drama, which I didn't think much of back then. And when people used to say that, okay, you know, I think you'll end up getting into acting because I was modeling for pocket money's sake, nothing more than that. So at that time I was like, no, there's no way. There was once my school teacher who bullied me into performing a very small cameo kind of a part on stage during one of the house plays, saying if you don't do that, I will not let you host the function.
Okay.
So I should love
oration.
Hosting. Just public speaking was something I really enjoyed. So she was like, if you don't do the play, that part, I'm not going to let you host. So that was the only time I was forced to do a little bit, which must be horrible, I'm sure. So it's not like I never said never to any opportunity.
Yeah.
That I think worked in my favor. I don't know when the transition of liking this happened. It happened over a period of time. But when people ask me, when did you decide that you want to be an actress? I say after my first film released.
It's really interesting.
Yeah, because by that time I was just trying to just experiment with life. I had finished my engineering. I thankfully had a campus placement in Infosys. I did not join it. It was just to prove it to my parents that if I want, I can get it. It's just that I don't want to do it. I want to do something else. And I want to do my MBA. I wanted to, I gave my CAT, I got around 88th percentile, and I thought I could do more because I was that geeky, nerdy front bencher student, the annoying one in the class. So I thought I could do better, MBA being my last degree, I thought. So I thought I'd drop 1 year, and meanwhile, just experiment with life, learn new things. And I was getting these movie offers from South, took one of those, two actually.
It was like an experiment.
Yeah, like just like my filmography, everything has been an experiment.
So once you knew that you want to do this, how do you pick your roles? Because you really didn't have a guiding force. Mm. So how do you know what is right, what is wrong, who's the right person to meet and who should you not meet, you know? All of that is important.
The right person to meet or not meet, you learn over a period of time by making mistakes.
Right.
Be it in your personal life or professional life. You have to meet a lot of wrong people to know that they are wrong.
Right.
So it took me a little while, but how I judge my scripts even now, after I started realizing what acting is about and how filmmaking really happens, which I'm still learning, but the more I learned, I realized once I hear a script, the first thing I think is, will I spend my hard-earned money on this film, to buy a ticket of this film at the box office and watch it in theater? Will I spend those dedicated 2.5-3 hours to go all the way to a theater and watch this film and, you know, not feel that committed time based
over? It's worth my time and money.
I should not. Do I feel like that for this particular script? That, if yes, then the first step is done. Then, of course, second one comes into my, as my character. Will I make such an impact on my audience? I want all of you to take me back home when you walk out of the theater. So that's always one thing that I keep in mind. Will they remember me when they leave the theater?
Right.
If yes, then the second option is also checked. And the third one, which is a little more dramatic or a little more filmy side of me, I really want my kids to be proud of the filmography I've had, because one day when all of this ends, I'm sure I would love to have a family and then have kids, and I would really want to show them what I did in life. And when they see it, they should not feel awkward and embarrassed, like, what the hell? So yeah, they might as well feel proud of what their mother could do, so that's why.
There must have been times when you probably lost the film to another actor. It happens all the time in the industry.
For all of us.
And you didn't have the typical, you know, what we call a godmother, the godfather. So did those moments make you angry? Did those moments teach you a lot?
Of course they make you really angry. And as I told you the other day, my anger management has become better with time in this film industry. I used to have a really short fuse back in college. Very, very temperamental. I am still very moody, but that's thanks to my profession, because I think all actors are moody. That's one of the work hazards that we have here. Before that, I was really temperamental, and I think I've built up patience for a lot of bullshit in my life now. So yeah, it took me
the territory, I guess. Yeah.
I have lost out on a lot of films, sometimes because of reference calls made by someone. Sometimes because they thought, okay, she doesn't, in the beginning of the career, because you don't get bums on the seat, as I've learned the new term, bums on the seat in theater. So that's why. And sometimes just because your hero doesn't want you, sometimes because the hero's previous film has failed, so the budget of the film has suddenly dropped. So it's the, it's me who has to compromise on my paycheck, or just, I'm just shown the gate. Otherwise, we can leave. So I prefer to choose the gate.
But you also said that being an outsider has helped you. Tell us how.
That does. So I honestly, I've lived my life in a way that I would rather see the glass half full.
Right.
So even though I've probably had some wonderfully nasty experiences here, but I really want to, I think, I look at it and think, what am I taking back home in a positive way? Right. So being an outsider, I think the fact that this is almost houseful today is probably because most of you feel that how I talk or what I do on screen resonates with a lot of you. Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah? Thank God. So yeah, I think that's because of my very regular middle class upbringing of being an outsider. I have seen life through my eyes and not through those tinted glasses with a silver spoon. I've seen it as probably most of you have. Live a similar kind of life with a regular kind of a childhood and never been over protected or over pampered. So I think that really helps me to present these kind of characters on screen more convincingly.
Right.
So that's why all of you might relate to my characters and find it more real, is because I've lived a part of most of the characters that are present on screen in real as well.
Yeah. You said that that's your USP, that people relate.
That's
to
my biggest strength.
Is it also because the audience wants to see real stories and find real heroes in unreal situations?
It is true. I think I blame it on Instagram, because all of us today want to be want to have the maximum likes and maximum attention everywhere. All of us, we have learned to be the hero of our own stories. We want to be the hero of our own stories. And when we see someone on screen who's a protagonist of a film who is flawed but real, we feel that if that person can do it, maybe I can also do it. Then you probably somewhere start seeing yourself in that person. And that's why the success of all these films where the protagonist is a relatively regular looking person, I think the success is just going exponentially high lately. And characters like these exist now because of everyone now feeling that they can also be the hero of their lives. Yeah.
You spoke about how at one point you were getting all these packaged films, the really commercial tropes, typical ones. And then you have these feature films like your Pink, Manrazia, Mulk, all of these films. So were you consciously trying to break away from the typical TV format?
Let's be honest. Yeah. When I started, I did Chashmeh Wadood, and you know, I have to say this, this is very nostalgic. I shot the climax of Chashmeh Wadood right outside this premise. Like just outside. It was my first Hindi film and I was here for that in Goa. We shot the entire film here. So after that film finished, it was a regular kind of a commercial potboiler, which was probably a regular vehicle for a girl to get into mainstream cinema. And who would say no to a David Dhawan film? I wouldn't, even now. So I did it, and then it got relatively good response. And then I was like, okay, now what next? And I realized that whichever film I want to be in, there's someone who's really good at it. You know, there are a lot of girls who are actually good at doing these commercial portfolios. They still are. And they're all being backed by someone or the other, being recommended by someone or the other. And generally, because they're good at it, they're getting it. So I'm like, okay, this is too crowded a space here. And I don't think I can get an edge over them because there's no one backing me up here. And plus, these girls are really drop-dead gorgeous and really doing a good job. So let me find a new path.
Create your own space.
Create my own space. It's going to be difficult. It's going to be longer. It's going to take hell lot of time and effort. There will be rejections of some weirdest sort. It's going to be painful sometimes, mentally, physically. But I think when I get it, it will be so strong as a base that nobody can claim that it's because of them that I'm here.
Absolutely. Yes.
So today, I'm like, even though it's been slow and steady, it's extremely steady. So it's not like someone can say that, okay, if I take away my support, this girl will be
fall apart.
Yeah, this girl won't be there anymore. Nobody can claim their major part in my success.
Right.
So I think that is, it's worth it.
Yeah.
And I'm happy with where I am.
The most actors can very rarely play a negative role, like, you know, I love that film.
Thank you.
And in the original film, the Spanish film, the protagonist is the negative character.
Yes, yes.
You turned it on its head and you went to Shiva and said, this is what I want to do.
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know how many of you guys, have you guys seen Badla?
हिंदी में भी बोलो क्योंकि हिंदी फिल्में आप करती हैं।
मैं तो पूरा हिंदी में बात कर सकती हूँ।
सारे लोग आपकी हिंदी फिल्म देख कर आए।
अच्छा सबको हिंदी समझ में आएगी हिंदी में
बात। नो 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 नो
यस
So why English? She is a Hindi actress.
Sir, I'm a South Indian actress also. Tamil Telugu baat karo.
मैक्सिमम पीपल हिंदी
समझते
हैं।
सर वो वाली डिबेट ना हम किसी और टाइम और सब्जेक्ट और चीज के लिए रख देते हैं। Okay, so what is the question? So Badla. So I don't know how many of you guys know about the story behind how Badla happened. So the person who had the rights to this Spanish film reached out to me saying this is the film. And I was in the original film, the Spanish film, the character I played was played by a man. And my boyfriend in the film who dies, who eventually I murder, sorry for the spoiler, that character was to be played by me. That was how I was offered the film. When I saw the film, I said, can I do this boy's part if you haven't casted anyone. I told this to producer because there was no one attached to the film other than the person who had the rights and me. So I, when I asked him, he took a day to think, he came back, he said, okay, fine, we haven't finalized anyone. I think it's fine if you want to flip it into a woman, because it'll be interesting to see a woman, but are you sure you want to do it? I said, of course I want to do it. It's a candy for an actor to do that character. So I said yes, and then I was signed and everything. And it took us like, I think, over a year and a half or so to find a director who could do it, or the person who could play the lawyer's character. So it took us almost a year and a half to find Shijoy and Mr. Bachchan to come on board. And when Mr. Bachchan got to know that I'm playing that character, his first reaction, why does Tapsi want to play a negative role? So he was like, why want to play that role? It's such an amazingly layered and shaded character. So I was like, I'll give my right, left arm, whatever, for that role. So that's how it happened. And it probably shook me a little bit to realize that we have come to a stage where a female actor can actually say, I want this part, even though it's male's part, and flip it, and people will agree to it. But sorry to disappoint you all, let's keep the chapter a little later, because soon after, recently, I've lost a film because I'm a female actor, because they wanted a male actor, because then the budget of the film will be higher and they could spend more. So let's give a long video.
We still have a long video. My next question was just that, you know, we spoke about how the audience is evolving, and yes, they are. But there's certain sections still wants to see women play righteous actors.
Yeah.
Good women, bad women, nothing in between. Yeah. And we have to fit into some moral compass all the time. Do you find that's the zone conflict when you're taking a role like that? Like Barla, in Manmaz, yeah, role is not evil or negative.
Yeah,
it's great. You're still confused.
It's
weird. The woman doesn't want to marry. I mean, that's a big deal for us, right?
Yeah.
How do you pick these roles?
Manmazi again has a different story, how I said yes to it. But I'll tell you what, I think it's sari zimmedari, the whole responsibility of being the most righteous and white character. Why it has to be on the woman all the time? Either she has to be the vamp, just clearly a vamp. Or she has to be Sita Mata ka avatar all the time. No. There's a reason why Sita Mata is Sita Mata, because she's a goddess and we pray to her, and I'm not a goddess. I'm a normal human being. So that's why we need to keep it real. So they came to me with Manmazia, and it's again very funny. First of all, Anurag questioned me. I love Anurag as a person, as a friend. He is one of the most bankable human beings you can have in your lives, contrary to a lot of other beliefs about him. But as a director, I've not seen all his films, and I'm not fond of his films mostly.
He knows that.
He knows that. Of course, he knows that. So there are few films of his I like, and few I don't at all. So when I got to know that it's him who's directing it, I'm not sure if I fit into an Anurag Kashyap film. I don't see myself as an Anurag Kashyap hero here. So when I heard the story and Kanika Dhillon, the writer of the film, was narrating it to me, when I reached the narration, that part where she goes to the boyfriend after she gets married, and infidelity or whatever you call it, and by the end of the film, I was like, I don't think I approve of what she's done. Because Tapsi as a person, I'm very black and white in choices. Like, I know what I want. I'm not like Rumi at all, contrary to what most of people think, because my outlook is like that. I can behave like Rumi,
but
I don't think like Rumi. Right. So I said, you know, this is the part I don't approve of as Tapsi, so I don't know if I can convincingly portray it on screen, because I wouldn't do it in my life. So Kanika said, you know, minus this part, it's a cakewalk for you. Because I do have that kind of outlook, as I told you. So if you remove this part, there's no challenge for you in this film. And that hit me really hard. And someone just throws a challenge at me.
Take it on.
So I'll call it a Sardarni Dilli attitude or whatever. I'm like, you tell me I can't do it, I will do it and show it to you. So yeah, so that's how I said yes to Manmazia. And first thing I met Anurag, I was like, listen, I'm not like this in real life, let me just tell you. but I'll still do it.
You convince him of that.
Yeah, but thankfully, I think it landed fine. Did it land fine?
Yes.
Oh, thank God. I did have some elderly aunties come and tell me that, you know, it's such a wrong thing to do this. Why will you show such kind of a thing in a film that, you know, the woman goes to the boyfriend again? It is not right to show. Ma'am, I'm not making a textbook documentary. Sorry. So that's how I get
happening. So
yeah, exactly. And it's, let's just say, it's inspired by a lot of real events in a lot of women's lives.
I'm just asking, you know, who would think a 30-year-old of the actress would play the role in the Lucy Evans? And what is fascinating is the fact that you signed on this film when you were shooting the Jurwa film, which is the most glamorous role of your life.
Yeah.
So we can't even see it as a contrast, like a different universe. So what were you thinking at that point? You were looking your most glam self and then cut to a 60-year-old.
I think that was the reason. Because then I was doing that. That's why in life in general, I'm a hyperactive person. I get bored doing one thing at a time. That's why I just say I'm jack of all trades, master of none, probably. While I was doing Jurwa, is when I read this, I saw Sankhyaank and Badla,
okay.
Both. So when I was doing Jurwa, I was like, okay, this is done, but I definitely don't want to do the same thing anytime soon. So I was on this lookout for what different, what new, what is more interesting, and that's how I ended up taking up all these films, which are totally opposite to what I did in Jurwa.
Any fear while signing on the role?
No, I don't.
Never.
No, I only thing is that I told you my criteria. I should spend money. I think I actually see myself as a very regular, average Indian woman. Okay, so I think about a film, I clearly say, ye main theater mein kyun dekhne jaun? Isme kya hai aisa jo main
dekhne? That's a filter when you're looking at it.
Yeah. So I think like that, if I feel like I can watch it, I think a lot of people will watch it. So that's why I don't get scared. I don't have a surname to protect. I am not answerable to a family or a lineage saying that ye film karni hai, ye nahi karni, because I have to take the responsibility of the family ahead and all that. I don't have that. That's why I say I have an edge being an outsider.
Right.
That I don't have that lineage to protect.
No such pressure.
No, sir, not at all. So, and I never wanted to be an actor. Right. So it's not like I have dreamt of reaching that number one position in my life. I'm here because I'm having fun.
Right.
Until the time I'm having fun, I'm going to be here doing everything random that you think I cannot do. I'll do it. The day I get bored, if I keep getting the same kind of part and if the scripts are not addressing me anymore, I will very happily, gracefully climb that ladder down and do something else in life, because films are not my be-all and end-all of life. Contrary to a lot of suggestions that I've always gotten from my co-actors and people I work with, who say that you should not be saying this, that, you know, film, you don't want to act to the last breath of your life. How can you say that? I love every second of my life when I'm in front of camera. I think I prove that with my work, hopefully time and again. I don't have to say something that should sound right for people to buy into my films. I'll show them that I love my work on screen. I don't have to keep saying that I'm going to be breathing, eating films.
Right.
No, that's not what I wanted to do in my life, but I'm enjoying every bit of it. The day I don't, you will not. Because you'll see that on my face when I'm not enjoying my work. And that day, it's better I gracefully climb down and do something else, what I enjoy, because guys, it's just one life. I don't want to regret or do something forcefully, drag myself out of bed every day to go to work. I don't want to do that. So till the time I'm having fun, you guys are loving my work, thankfully that's why I'm here. And you know, all good things are happening, I'm here. The day I feel I'm not enjoying it, it's getting difficult for me to go to work every day, it's not fun anymore, I do something else.
So your random films are doing really well, and that's why
it's your random films.
No, the interesting fact is, yes, you know, great films are being made for women right now. But also the fact that A-list actors with successful, prominent actors like you and Moni are coming to the fore and doing some cinema together and sharing screen space.
Yeah.
The general concept is that in our industry, it's hard to get men, A-list actors to come together.
Mm.
You're like a movie like Vishan Mangal. Five women.
Yeah.
So what are the thoughts behind that?
So, Mission Mangal came to me much later after Sankhyaank, right? Because it took us like a long time to find people to do Sankhyaank. When I heard Sankhyaank's script, I actually went out to that film rather than the film coming to me, because I wanted to work with another actress at the same level. Because in my head I was thinking it would be so much fun to see two equal level actresses sharing equal screen space on screen.
So you actually want to share screen space?
I wanted to share screen space. I went out, I knew whoever I knew around, I asked them if there's a script which has two or three female characters sharing equal screen space, because I really want to do that. And that's when I got to know Reliance has the script. And that's when I went out, I reached out, I made them have a meeting with, meet with Tushar, the director of the film. And that's when he showed me the picture of the two dadis, and I said, you know, okay, then that means I don't qualify to be in the film. He said, no, but I would want you to hear it. If you feel you can put in what is required for this film, let's do it. I heard the film. In 10 seconds, I said yes. Because there were 12 people in that room, in the office. I had live music for during the narration. Wherever the song came, there was a live music singing and all happening. And there were some 12 people there to convince, apparently, later I got to know, to convince me that you should do this film. Because they had heard so many no's for the film. They had heard so many times, no, after he probably was 60, probably because it's not glamorous, probably because there are two equal roles for the heroine and nobody wants to share the screen space equally. When I heard that, I immediately said yes, and I was like, please do me just one favor, find someone who is at par. I'm not saying just with the acting talent, there are some brilliant actresses around, but also in terms of perception in audience. Who is at par, who audience doesn't keep aside thinking this is a supporting role and this is a main role. So please make sure you choose another actress of the same level. And it took us 2 years to find Bhumi. 2 years.
That's really long.
Yeah, but then I'm happy because we both resonated in terms of what we wanted to see for the film. Our vision was so high, the goal was so far away. So both of us were not on two different sides of the line. We were on the same side of the line fighting for that big goal that we had kept for ourselves.
That helped, because both of you totally were on the same side.
We really enjoyed whatever time we spent on set, and even during promotions, we really enjoyed promoting the film together. We knew we are making history of certain sort. This will not come to us again.
Talk about a little baby, right? You had a very small role, I mean, 8-10 minutes too?
Yeah, 7 to 10 minutes, yeah.
But the film had an impact. And there are many other films after that.
Yeah.
So is the length of the role ever a deal breaker? Where should it really be?
The cliche answer is no, from an actor, but I'll give you a reason behind it. There are two things that I see when I get a film. By the way, I've done Surma, where my part was not the central role. I was in Mission Mangal, where I was again not either Akshay Kumar or Vidya Balan in the film. So, but I wanted to do it because I knew people will remember me when they walk out of the theatre. So, so when I got that part from Devi, at that point it was, I just came out of Chashmah Badoor and I just wanted to make an impact. I was like, they should just remember me and take me back home. And when I heard about this part, again, I was the one who went to Neeraj Pandey. It didn't happen the other way around. So when I went to Neeraj Pandey through the casting director, he didn't meet me immediately. He thought, you know, she was that typical girly kind of a character. I don't think she'd be into this agent role and all. So it took me a little while to get a meeting with Neeraj sir to convince him that I can do this part.
Yeah.
And thankfully got convinced after the meeting. But when people did not even want to acknowledge that I was in the film before the film released. So there were a lot of times when my PR used to go out and speak to media and tell them, you know, she's doing Akshay Kumar's film. And they were like, yeah, so what? Like, it's just, she's not even opposite Akshay Kumar. She doesn't have any songs in the film with him. And it's just a very small kind of a 7-10 minutes role. So what's the big deal? And I was like, you know, okay, let's just wait for the film to release.
Then we'll see.
And then, you know, that probably just, because they did not expect me to do it. So every time they don't expect me to do something, I do that. Is when I take a lot of attention from my audience. And that's been my formula for creating impact. And 7-10 minutes role doesn't matter. See, there are two criteria. Either you give me a substantial part, like the central part, or you know, whatever you call the main part, so to say, or you give me a small part, but you give me something new and interesting to do, which people don't expect out of me, or which will just, you know, create such a strong impact in the storyline. You give me that. So that is also okay.
Nothing in between.
Yeah. You're giving me a small part which, you know, is so insignificant that it comes and goes, nothing changes in the film.
There's nothing in between.
There's nothing. It's not fun to do it. Yeah.
You started your career in the Tamil industry, right?
Yeah.
And your first one was a huge success.
Yeah.
So you've seen the highs and lows in the South before you came to Bollywood.
Yes.
And that somehow prepared you what was ahead of you.
Oh, totally.
Totally toughening up.
Totally. I have heard the nastiest of shit.
You were almost called a curse at certain phases.
I was being devastating
for an actor, right?
For a girl, yes. Because at that time I did not even consider myself to be actor. I was like someone who's struggling. But for a female to be called a bad luck charm, wherever she's going, it's a little hurtful.
So how did that happen after how many?
That was like, I think 3 or 4 films back to back bombed at the box office in Telugu. Tamil, my frequency has been very less, but my success rate is extremely high. I've had most of the films of mine in Tamil have been good hits. So I just ventured into Hindi at that point, where I had these 3-4 flops in Telugu. And suddenly they all started writing articles on me and calling me as the iron leg, which is the bad luck charm of the industry. And I was staying alone by myself in Hyderabad at that point. A girl who had left Delhi to make a mark in the industry, just to give her all she had, was called this kind of a name time and again. My directors wanted to sometimes cast me, but their producers said no, just stay away from her and all. So I was kept on hanging for months for a lot of films, and then the director wouldn't convince the producer because they just thought it's just bad woman to take her. So that means I've lost a lot of films at that point. So it was a little sad, but thankfully Tamil was happening and Hindi had just started, so I could divert my time and attention. But had it been my only industry at that point, it would have been quite devastating for me to go through that. And yeah, I'm happy that it's over, and now there are a lot of girls who text me and from the industry now, South, who say, you know, I'm also going through that right now. And I'm like, if I can,
used to happen.
Yeah, it continues to happen. As I said, if I can get out of it, so can you.
Right.
Just hang on. Just don't leave it as yet. So that's what I end up telling them.
But it's interesting, we still do one film in the South
every year.
Is that because you really want to earn your reach as a family actress? Or is it also because both industries offer you a different pattern of roles? So you can pick and choose from Bollywood as well as the South industry.
Actually, it started from the fact that South has actually taught me what filmmaking is, right? It made me an actor. So there's a sense of gratitude I have for the Southern film industry, because that's where this new career or life started for me. This experiment worked out courtesy South film industry, both Tamil and Telugu, because I started simultaneously. So I think it started off as a sense of gratitude that at no point in time I ever wanted to look like I used it as a stepping stone to get into Bollywood. At no point. So, because I'm really happy, I was really happy giving it all I had, success, failure, both, whatever, it's part of life. But they taught me what light is, what camera is.
The basics.
Yeah. So I cannot leave it. And now I've learned the language. So it's kind of cool now to act in that language, as you know. And you're a Pan-India actor. How many people can really boast about the fact that a BC center in Andhra, Telangana or Tamil Nadu knows you as much as a BC center in Hindi speaking Delhi? So I think very few actors make that crossover successfully, and I don't want to leave that position. It would be really stupid of me to give up on that market just because it's perceived as Hindi's pan-India thing. No, I don't think so. I will continue to work in South.
So back to your very vocal on social media, like
you
express your opinions.
Me and my social media.
Yeah. But social media is a great platform to exchange ideas, views, have discussions. At the same time, there's a lot of negativity. There's bitterness, cynicism, all that exists there.
Yeah.
So how do you deal with all of that? And does it ever break your heart? Does it ever deeply affect any of these tools?
It used to in the beginning. Then I discovered block button. So
it took me a while
to realize that there's block and I can block. But then I realized that this, you know, these people who are saying the kind of nonsense they are saying, it is just purely to affect me and to win over. Okay, I had the power to affect this person, or I had the power to get a response from this person, and I don't want to feel them validated, or the fact that they won. I don't want them to feel like that. So now what I've started doing is I don't even blog them anymore as much as I used to before. I look through. I think indifference is the biggest form of revenge of this sort, I think. When you look through someone, that another person doesn't exist, I think it's extremely hurtful to do that. So I do that. Sometimes I'm stuck in traffic. I have a lot of time in Mumbai, as everybody knows. Traffic is like my social media friend, because I sit there in my car just scrolling through some nonsense messages on social media and then reply to one or two because I'm probably in a good mood at that point. I use my little bit of sense of humor that I have to respond to it, to entertain the real followers
like
I have.
Just
to have some fun and so that my social media followers know what kind of a person I am, because I am like that.
Right.
I end up twisting it and making it look funny, mostly sarcastically funny, because that's my kind of sense of humor. So I do that. But it doesn't affect me to an extent that it'll hurt me or anything anymore. I mean, in the beginning of my career it did, when I used to get these messages from my father saying, you should not reply to these people. These people are going to spoil your reputation. And my dad used this official email kind of a format. You should not be talking to these people. So I stopped doing that. And I thought, you know, these people, they don't deserve my attention. They don't affect me. Only the people who are close to me in my life, in my circle, are the ones who have the power to affect me.
Right.
I will not let these people get that power to affect me.
Let me say a compliment to our family. So how long did it take your parents to come around and understand the starting business and accept you for all of
this? I don't think they still get it.
You and giving you all the important.
I don't think they still get it. They still are there back in Delhi. I'll give you a small instance. I went to a hospital recently for some small help from a doctor. And I was sitting in the room with my mother, and I had just come after some stitches on my leg. So my mother was sitting with me, and there were people from the hospital, from different departments, who kept coming in. And I couldn't even stand at that point because the stitch was fresh. So I couldn't stand up, so I was lying on the bed, and they kept coming and asking for pictures. And my mom or dad, whoever was there in the room, was looking at my face when they asked for pictures, expecting me to handle it or, you know, what do you want to do types. I'm like, I'm on the bed. Like, you know, in a proper, if someone looks at me, they'll be like, no, please take rest, you know. Wouldn't want to disturb her. But there were people from hospital coming, and my mother and father did not know how to handle it. I go back home, and then the kids in the society see that I've come back home. And sometimes I go back home lately for only like few hours. You know, I just go in the evening and come back next day in the morning. And I want to spend time with my family because they're getting old. My parents, I really want to spend time with them. So then these kids will start coming at 12 o'clock, 1 a.m. in the night, ringing the bell. And then they just don't want to click picture and go. They want to sit and talk.
Have a conversation with you.
But they'll not talk. They just look at my face. So I literally feel like I'm a Qutub Minar in the house. So that's eating into my time that I want to spend with my parents, which is very precious for me with the kind of work I do, where I don't get time anymore. So I'm like, please, mom, I told mom and dad, don't open the door. They can't understand.
They think it's very rude.
I'm like, but I want to spend time with you, and you know, they don't let me do that. So they don't get it.
They don't get it yet.
And they don't get
it.
Isn't
it also really nice and comforting, the normalcy?
Of course that is. That is what makes my head stay on my shoulders.
Right.
My sister, my parents, they're as regular as anyone else in the country. And they still have those orthodox, conventional notions about life and how you should lead a life. And everything that a middle class family talks about, we talk about. So it really makes me feel at home, normal. I don't have all these fancy pictures of mine from my films and all at my house, either in Mumbai or in Delhi. I don't have any awards, not that I've gotten many, but I don't have any of those anywhere displayed in my house, because when I enter my house, I want to feel like
it's a normal house.
I don't have any of those. I only have my childhood pictures at a couple of places in my room. But that's about it. I don't keep all of that because when it's packed up, it's packed.
So vanity be damned.
Yes.
Totally, I don't. There's nothing like that.
I have cut and pack up in my life, unlike probably a lot of other actors.
So you spoke of sexism in the South industry. You also spoke of pay parity across industries, right? And in our industry, it's common that a hero's package is almost as much as a budget of an entire woman-driven film, right? In an interview, Transcendent, you also said that a producer once told you that cost-cutting karenge kyunki ye women-centric film hai, mainstream nahi. And that kind of hurts.
It still happens.
So that is changing slowly, but the fact that, you know, women like you and Bhumi coming to the fore and doing the kind of cinema you're doing, Deepika, and demanding what you deserve, is that going to change the scene?
I hope I see that change in my lifetime. That's my wish. That's my wish. It is. We have a long way to go. It's insane. I mean, I probably will not say a generalized number, but it's not even half of the leading men. It's way less, not even 1/4 at times, honestly, even less. As I said, that the cost of, or actually half of the salary of a big hero is the entire budget of a female-driven film of an A-lister. I'm not even saying.
That says something.
Yeah, that's the difference. I hope it changes in my lifetime. I would love to see that change. That will happen when more and more people walk into a female-driven film in theater and watch it.
Right.
Only box office can change this. Right. Yes, we are making film. The frequency of the female-driven films has increased drastically in the last 4-5 years. But the big difference will only come when the numbers come in. There is no other way. I think nobody can question the quality of films. Okay, I actually beg to differ if anyone does, because the female-driven films are equally good or bad. Right. But even like some male-driven so-called bad films get huge numbers.
Yeah.
So why not for females then?
Right.
So yeah, that's still sad. I hope I see that change in my lifetime. Long way to go though.
Right. If you could relive one moment from one of your own movies, one particular moment or scene, which one would that be?
I want to live a moment, there are actually quite a few
so
things.
Many.
Yeah. Pink, I'll tell you one or two films of mine which I had more. In Pink, when I finished that, my first breakdown in the court, having Amitabh Bachchan stand up and clap and hug me after that was surreal. And actually, more than that, if I may say so, in Mulk, after I delivered that final statement, it was a 2-page long statement that I delivered. And we were shooting with 5-6 cameras. There were 100-110 people in the audience sitting there in the court. After I delivered that statement, I only gave one take for that because I was so prepared to finally just blurt it out the way I wanted to. So that finished, and after cut, everyone's like all those 100 people stood up and clapped, and there was one gentleman there who wrote on a piece of paper that you'll become the number one actress of the film industry very soon. He signed it, he wrote a date on it. He gave me that paper. He said, I thought maybe he's coming to take a picture. He said, no, I don't want a picture. I just want to give it to you. Please remember this. And I still did have that paper in my wallet. It's not that I want to become number one. That probably just sometimes makes you take decisions. I don't want to pressurize myself with that. But just a gesture of a random person who's just sitting there as an observer, and he's probably the audience, right?
Right. Yeah.
And doing that, making that effort, out of not like he gets something in return from me. Just that, give me a sense of like how much power do you have as an artist,
right,
as an actor, to affect someone so deeply. So that was one of the most memorable moments. So yeah, these nights.
How about Mr. Bachchan, who you worked with? If he has a retrospective on Mr. Bachchan's popular films.
Mm.
So if you were to cast yourself, you know, so considering you were approach so many producers and directors. So if you were to go and approach someone and say, I want to act with Mr. Bachchan in one of his films, which one would it be? Across his career span. Opposite him.
I understand. Let's just Chini come. I think it was a very sweet film and Tabu was brilliant.
Yeah.
Oh, what a beautiful film. If I had to cast opposite him, because see, as we mentioned rightfully, I've not seen films while growing up during school time because my parents were not really interested to go to theatres or take me to theatre.
Right.
The only film I saw probably in my school time was Chota Chetan.
That's really school time.
Yeah, because that was in the summer holidays to-do list.
Hmm.
So I never saw those films. The only films I saw probably was during lunch or dinner time on television while we were having our food. Yeah, whatever was there. So only after college I started going out and watching films with my friends. So I think Chini Kam is that one of those films that I've seen, and I'm like, oh, I can do this too.
Now, you also said that you never date a man who is from the industry.
Yeah.
How are you so sure?
Never date a man. I would never date a man.
So what? In the sense of normalcy, and you want a non-family life once you're back home, is that the reason?
Yes. Yeah. I have a curtain pack up in life. I want to have life beyond films. I have a life beyond films. No matter how much you say that you are not going to discuss films at home, you're not going to have those discussions or those topics. Inherently, you know, the other person might be going through kind of a mood swing or something bad or good that has happened at work, and my partner would want to share that with me. And I can't say that don't share,
right,
because I don't want to talk about the film.
Yeah.
No, of course you want to share the good and bad moments of your partner's life. And I don't want to force that person not to talk about that.
Mm-hmm.
And of course I would also want to talk about some really interesting or good thing that happened or a bad thing that happened. So I just don't want those to be always the topic of discussion at home. So that was one of the reasons. And yeah, I wanted to have a life beyond films.
Yeah. There is creative hyper energy. You do various things, right? Other than acting. Does it also help you, hone your skills as an actor, contribute to, you know, the way you are as an actor?
Of course, because your life feels very real, right? I see people with my, as I say, with my eyes and not tinted glasses. I have a wedding planning company. I own a badminton team in the Premier Badminton League because I love sports. So I try to keep all these interests alive,
right,
because then it lets me see life from a different point of view.
Yeah.
And that point of view really matters, because that helps me grow as an actor. And as I told you before, it helps me portray those real characters on screen.
Yeah.
So it doesn't look like a cliche art and all that. So it helps me grow as a human being.
Yeah.
And hence as an actor as well.
You know, like, money is important, obviously, like we spoke about, films have to work. But money is not the only motivator for you. Like, you refuse endorsement for a fairness claim because you have a certain principle, and that would embed. Tell us about that.
That, again, thanks to the middle class upbringing, I know how much I spend in a month. My dad makes sure.
Your dad handles the financials.
He handles my finances. He makes sure he tells me this is your expenditure and you've gone overboard this month, or you've you're in control this month. So I know how much money I'll spend in a month. So once I secured that much, that okay, this much so I'll get from whatever investments I've done or whatever. So my monthly life is sorted. So beyond that, I did not really have to get greedy in life, because my living standards are very basic. I don't have an overtly plush lifestyle. I feel so when I see other actors and actresses. I don't have that. So I think that way is very easily maintained. So after that, I realized, not that before that also, I had to bend my rules, because as I told you, my motivation every day is to get excited to go to work. If I'm thinking I'm going there only to earn money and not to enjoy, it's not exciting enough for me to do that. So there was never a family responsibility pressure that I had to take care of people in my family financially. So I never had to make those decisions to take up things against my morals and ethics. So after I secured that basic monthly thing as money that I want to sustain, after that, so there's no way now. I don't do films or roles that, in the beginning of my career, I did do roles which probably I wouldn't do now.
But you don't regret those.
I don't regret those. Because that helped me know what not to do.
Yes.
And then I did a mistake. So I will not do those now. I don't have to. So the films, the characters, the endorsements, my appearances, I even refuse to go to an event where they had this get fair and all these kind of things. Things were there and I had to pose in front of that. I said I will not.
Clearly refuse those.
I don't want to do that. So I still don't do it.
Well, we know that you totally made it on your own in the industry, actually. Are there people who consider your mentors? Are there people in the industry who will watch your back? Who you could really count on?
I think
Anurag and anybody else.
Most of them, not just Anurag. I think most of my directors are the ones who I think I can count on. Mentor, it's not like I go to anyone to tell me if I should do it or no. I don't do that. Because good or bad, let it be my decision.
Choices are yours.
Yeah, because tomorrow I don't want to turn back and say, "Aapne kaha tha mujhe karne ke liye." It's because of you I've done this, and now it's your mistake. I can't do that.
Right.
So it has to be my decision. So most of the directors I've worked with, if I don't know how many of them noticed the fact that most of them have repeated me. David Dhawan, Shirish Sarkar, Neeraj Pandey, Anurag Kashyap, Anubhav Sinha, hopefully Shijoy in the future as well. I end up working with them again because I built a great rapport with them. And I think that's what the support system is about, that I know that they'll have my back, that I can come back
right.
to them, they can come back to me saying, well, let's work together. Mm-hmm. That works. It has kept me going till now.
Mm-hmm. You just spoken about how you're not, movies are the only thing you want to do,
yeah.
of the interest that you have. At the same time, I want to ask you, are you fiercely competitive within your space where you put it for yourself?
Oh, I am. With myself, yes. I used to be a very competitive person in school. I'll give you one instance. They used to force me to play basketball in okay. school because I had decent height.
You're good at sports, right?
I was yeah, good at yeah. sports. I used to try my hand at all possible sports.
Right.
Not that I was brilliant at any, but I used to just love trying.
Yes.
So they forced me into basketball because I had decent height. I just wanted to stand at the defense with my hand up there,
yeah.
making sure the ball is not going to the basket. So that was like, okay, fine. Now I've come into it. Now I have to win. Though I know in my head I don't know the game.
Right.
How could I lose? So the day I lost my big basketball match, I came back home and I had temperature. Because I was just fuming from inside, how could I lose? I'm telling you, I used to have this psychologically short,
I can't lose kind of thing.
I can't lose. And like, if you think logically, perhaps you don't even know this game. You were just standing there with your hand up. How do you expect yourself to win in such a scenario? But I was like, I couldn't take losing. So that also this industry taught me.
I was going to ask you that. Has industry really taught
me? Yeah, that's
taught me.
That's why I said
my patience.
My patience level has increased drastically after getting into this industry. I have learned how to take a lot of, be it, you know, losing out or a lot of nonsense, as I tell you. I have taken up that now.
And come back to the game again.
Yeah, yeah. I've been Phoenix for multiple times.
Sorry?
I've been a Phoenix. Multiple times, and I think I'll continue to be.
Lastly, any dream roles? Anything that you would like?
I want to be an Indian superhero in Avengers. That's my dream role. I'm like in Wonder Woman. Yeah, my Wonder Woman, she's already taken, so that's okay. She can have it. But I really, really want to do a superhero part. I'm a huge fan of X-Men, Avengers, and all that, and I love Robert Downey Jr. I can be his. I can be the Ant-Man suit. I cried in that last Avengers when he died. I cried. People looking at my face is like, this woman is crying in a superhero. I was like, how can he leave and go? I'm leaving him Instagram DMs and then he's come back.
Well, lastly, what has been the biggest learning in so many years of your career in Bollywood and South?
Never say never. First of all, that. And nothing is be all and end all of life. Nothing, trust me, life is very beautiful. It's only your point of view that needs to change. If this is not working, shift the camera and the lens to the other side. It is nothing is be all and end of life. You've gotten this one precious life. Please make most of it. Don't think that yahin pe matlab I'll keep trying to the last breath and all that. No, if it's not working, give yourself a deadline. Okay, this is not working. Let me try something else. Maybe something else is meant for you. Life is what happens when you're busy making plans. So never say never.
So that's it.
Super. Thank you so much. Yay! We survived. There are still people in the hall. I like it. Thank you.
Questions?
Yes, sir.
This year, all your 4 years have been both critically and commercially.
Yes, it has been a special year.
Game Over.
Yes.
Mission Mangal and now Sankhya.
Sankhya, yeah.
And my question is, how did Shah Rukh Khan sir came on board for Badla as a producer? And I am from Bangalore. When we can expect you a Kannada film?
Sir, what question are you asked? Okay, SRK, I mean, he came on board, I think after all of us, me, Shijoy, and Bachchan sir were on board. So we needed the person who will have the right acumen to release the film. Because guys, trust me, filmmaking is, yes, it's difficult and we go through a lot. But today, releasing a film, marketing it right and putting it out there for the right kind of people to watch it, it's a different ball game. And you really need some really intelligent and smart people who can think beyond to get that right. And I'm so happy with Badla that we had SRK sir, because if you see, Badla didn't have any songs, we didn't have any comedy happening, we had most of the film shot in, across the table between me and Mr. Bachchan. Who would have thought that film will touch a 19 domestic? Who would have thought? We didn't think. But thanks to the brilliance of, you know, Red Chillies, that this happened, that they could foresee that this is new, can be something new for the audience to watch and people will take it. So he came in the fag end and did the first job of putting the film rightfully across to people in the best possible way. And Kannada, sir, when I learned Kannada language now, then I will try, because I've realized without knowing language, I cannot give my 100% as an actor. So I learned Tamil and Telugu after getting there. But Kannada, I'll try when I am a little familiar with the language.
Rafi,
you can ask me, Mr. Ali. Yes, tell me. I was asking that
in 2019, because it's 50th year, चूंकि ये गोवा में हो रहा है, आपका गोवा से किस तरह का अनुभव रहा है, मतलब यहाँ पे थोड़ा पार्टी भी करने का और फिल्मों का जो फेस्टिवल होता है वो किस तरीके से लोगों के बीच में फिल्म देखने के लिए और प्रोत्साहित करता है इन तीनों के साथ?
ये आपने अपना जो पूछ लिया है रेगुलर वन ऑन वन में आपने यही पे निपटा लिया है. 50th गोल्डन जुबली है तो मेरा पहला साल है इसी का. एक्चुअली काफी आज कुछ सालों से कोशिश कर रही हूँ कि आ पाऊँ, बट हर बार कुछ ना कुछ शूट कर रही होती तो नहीं आ पाती. बट आई एम हैप्पी इस साल आई हूँ. आई कुड मीट सो मेनी पीपल, सो आई गेट वेरी इंटिमिडेटेड एंड नर्वस व्हेन आई हैव टू कम फॉर फिल्म फेस्टिवल्स. आई हैव बीन टू अ फ्यू लेटली इंटरनेशनली एज वेल. आई फील दैट दीज पीपल इन माई हेड, आई नो दैट दीज पीपल नो मच मोर अबाउट फिल्म देन आई डू, बिकॉज दे प्रॉब्ली वर वेरी क्लियर दैट दे वॉन्टेड टू गेट इन टू फिल्म इन सम वे ऑर द अदर. मेरे को नहीं पता था, सो आई ऑलवेज फील दैट मेरे को नहीं पता है, पता नहीं कुछ ऐसा पूछ लिया, पता नहीं मेरी बात समझ में आ रही है कि नहीं. सो आई गेट वेरी इंटिमिडेटेड व्हेन आई गो टू फिल्म फेस्टिवल्स. सो वो थोड़ा सा नर्वसनेस रहती है मुझे फिल्म फेस्टिवल्स आते हुए. और क्या था
आपका?
गोवा में चश्मे मतूर शूट करी थी, तो पहली हिंदी फिल्म यहाँ शूट करी थी, तो ये मेरे को हमेशा उस वजह से तो याद रहता ही है. मेरे को तो बहुत प्रोत्साहित करता है देख के कि अभी ये लोग सब सुन रहे हैं मुझे, मतलब कुछ तो अच्छा क्यों होगा लाइफ में, मतलब मैंने के थ्रू में मेरे को ये तो बहुत एनकरेजमेंट देता है कि कुछ तो ठीक ठाक कर रही हूँ मैं. थैंक यू.
Hello, Tapsi ma'am, how are you?
I'll come back to you.
Let the person with the mic say it. I'll ask you next. Hello, Tapsi ma'am, my name is Suraj and I'm from Puri. First of all, congratulations for your well-deserved success in the Indian film industry.
Thank you.
And talking about Rumi, talking about Manmazia, it not only landed well, but it hit hard and the audience sympathized with it.
Oh, thank you so much.
So my question is, when you get a part before, only a part for an audition, when a casting director gives you a part for an audition and you just have little idea about the scene, not the entire script, you haven't read the script. So how do you perceive the script and how do you think that what casting director wants from you and how do you perceive the audition? Thank you.
I'll give you an answer for this, but let me just give you a statutory warning. It will not really help you. I'll tell you why. I have failed in all auditions of my life. I have failed even the ad auditions. I've been horrible. Because I'll tell you why. Because I was not as clear as you are that what you want to do. I was just experimenting and I knew I was not good in acting, but I was getting work because of recommendations of the people who I worked with, not because of anything else. So when I worked with David Dhawan, he probably saw something in me and he said, okay, with regard to, I would want this girl. Now when I worked with Neeraj Pandey and Devi, he thought that there could be a prequel or a spin-off of this character and she'd be good at it. So the people who gave me work because of my work. So and I've failed all the possible auditions because I had the same problem. I'm not a trained actor. So I don't know how to, like, suddenly in one scene and you switch off with this one spotlight on your face with this one camera looking at you and you've just been told just do this scene. I never understood that. So till date, I say the same thing. Please don't take my audition. Not because I'm like, oh, I'll not give audition. No, because I'm really bad in auditions. I don't know how to perform an audition. So they, aapko pata chal jayega na kya karna hai, mujhe bata dena. Theek hai? We are in the same boat in this.
One more thing. I have heard in your interview, one of interview, that you, when you get a character, first you look at which person near you or from your family or nearby you is relating or resembling the character. So you get ideas from that. But what do you do when you get a get such character that there's no one around you see like that character, imaginary character, and how do you create?
I just find one character sketch of that character I have to portray. That I can link with myself. Okay, so wo ek common thread mil jaye, then I build over it, and of course the director is there, my director's actor, he'll help me and all. I need to find that one common thread that I can reach out through to reach, touch that character. I'll build over it with the help of my director, that's all. Let me ask that, that poor guy, yeah, please.
I know a little bit English.
You speak, which language do you speak?
Tamil.
Tamil to you, for you.
Okay. இது மாதிரி பாடல்கள் வந்து பெண்கள் வந்து அதிகமா பாடலுக்கு மட்டுமே ஹீரோயின் யூஸ் பண்ணி பட்
சம்மன் ஹேவ் டு ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் ஆ बिकॉज ஹவ் ஐ லைக் ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் இல்ல போட்டா எலிசி சே
ஐ ட்ரை டு இங்கிலீஷ்
ஓகே
மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி ஹீரோயின்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்ட் ஃபார் ஒன்லி சாங்ஸ் ஹவ் டு பிரேக் தட் ஸ்டீரியோடைப் tell me some suggestions.
Give them more films to do. What what else do you want? So it is because you know what they have said why it happens because most of the times directors or producers feel it's only the hero who gets the audience into theaters. So when the budget for the hero is given, director, music director, DOP, all the other major departments, the budget is done, what is the money left? Now let's find a heroine in that money, is how it has happened and probably still happens. But that is the situation. So if you have to break this, then obviously that vicious circle, na? You what you can do, I can tell you. You know, most of you probably are from film schools or you know, want to make films. So then do and make an attempt to make such a film. Or if you just want to be a good audience, walk into a theater, give a female-driven film a chance. Let the numbers come in. When a female-centric film becomes a box office success, when one female-centric film becomes a box office success, you have no idea. You have triggered some 5 to 10 female-centric films in making at that point. That's what it does. So that is how it will change.
Topsy, ma'am. Now you can top of the Indian cinema.
I'm not Topsy. Like how people in Chennai call you Topsy.
Hello. Shubham Pandey from Madhya Pradesh. Hello, ma'am. My question was already answered. Like I was expected to asking you about the superhero type of movies like Ravan and Shaktiman and all this. Like what kind of superhero film do you plan to make on Bollywood? So that is answered. The next question arises from the segment which is like about language barrier. You are born up as a Punjabi descent, as I studied that, and born and did schooling in Delhi. Mm-hmm. That is almost the Hindi belt. And debuted with the Telugu film Jhumani Nadam.
Jhumani Nadam.
Yeah, and also worked in Tamil and Malayalam.
Yeah.
How do you manage this? Like we as a Hindi people often suffer as like languages as a barrier. But did you take any coaching classes?
While I was acting in those films, I had to, na. I thought it was hard to go. I was told that it's okay. Most of the girls come from north. We teach them. I did not know it will be so difficult to learn a new language. I've never heard Tamil or Telugu in my life before that. But then once you are in it, you have to give your 100%. So even though it might sound like, "Arey, isko toh kuch karna nahi pada," she just got an opportunity easily. Yes, I might have gotten my first chance easily, but I think to my credit, I never take my opportunities for granted. Because that's it. That's the end of your career or life or any opportunity when you take it for granted. So I make sure I learn the language. I never took prompting in any of my films, in any languages, from my first film. Because I was like, guys, you have to do this much. In Telugu, I remember my first ever media appearance in Telugu when I had the audio launch of Jhumani Nadam. I made sure I learned my speech in Telugu because I wanted to reach out to my audience. This is, you know, if they're going to give me so much of love and accept a total outsider in the first film and make me a star, this is the least I can do. I can just learn a language to communicate to them. So I thought this is my job also as an actor to learn the language. I think it is equally important to know the language as much as you can and perform it well. It should go hand in hand. It shouldn't be like you just mouth ABC read something random and do it. No, it doesn't work like that.
Yeah, in that form the modulation differs a lot. So ma'am, finally, that question was not that much clear. That what kind of character it would be if you work in a superhero type of movie? What kind of character? That is, will it throw the spidey like or it will it...
Kuch kaam writer ke liye chhod dete hain. Sab kuch main hi karungi kya?
Okay, thank you.
Hello. Hello, I'm a filmmaker from North America.
And oh, hi.
I want to thank you, first of all, for speaking in English.
Oh, thank you. Okay, ma'am, I'm happy I could get through.
I've had a long career in North America, Vancouver, Los Angeles. There's an organization called Women in Film and Television International, and there is an office in Mumbai.
Okay.
Have you ever investigated this? Because this is a group of women internationally. There's 44 different chapters around the world. Germany, Mumbai.
I am not aware of it.
And basically, what we're trying to do is to get wage parity and to get better pay for women in the industry. This is something that I've been working for personally for about 15 years, to take the $10 million that the star gets and the $1 million that the female gets, and to bring those closer together. Mm-hmm. You, as you can see here, like, the audience is 50% female, 50% male, so why are the males getting paid more? I would encourage you, please, to investigate women in film. There's WIFTI in Mumbai, and they would love to have you be to join the organization, because we need women who are fighting for wage parity.
I would love to, ma'am. Yeah. I'm sure I would love to. But you know, everything has a logical reason. I'm sure you also have investigated enough into this matter and realized that money, it's eventually show business, right? It's business. It's meaning to, the producer cannot be overburdened with the money without the film making that much of money. So I think that's where it comes from. I'm not saying it's fair.
No.
But
no.
Yeah, someone has
the audience as well.
Yes, and as I told you, it's in the audience. It's when, you know, it's strange. When you think of idols, the men walking into a film theater are also cheering and hooting for the hero. And the women are also cheering and rooting for a hero who's a male. But when it comes to a female, it doesn't happen. So so as a male or a female audience, your idol is always the male protagonist, not the female protagonist, right? So I think that's where the discrepancy is. And I don't know how much it will make sense or people, how many people agree to the fact that when my last film released, Sankyak, very few films of mine have gone into theater to see the response of the audience. Like, let me see how they are reacting to the film, to know if they're liking it or no. First time ever, I have seen Indian audience in a regular theater clapping, cheering, screaming for a dialogue delivered by a 60-year-old character who's a female on screen. And not because she's just dancing in a bikini and looking hot and sexy, which is also difficult, let me tell you that. But yeah, it was a very refreshing visual for me to see that. And I think that has given me so much of confidence that, you know, if you have it in you, you can make films where you can get the cheer and applause from the audience, even if you're a female protagonist. So that's going to make us real heroes on screen. And that is going to get us money.
Exactly.
Right?
And if the writers and the directors start making more real roles for
it
real
is a vicious circle, man. Audiences comes in, directors make film, writers write film, and there are lots of film being written. In Indian cinema, I'm the last one to complain. I have 6 films to do in 2020, and all of them are me as a protagonist.
So you have power now to create change.
Yes.
Thank you for doing this.
I'm doing my part, man. Thank you.
Ma'am.
I would love to answer all of
ma'am.
You, but
we're talking about women in lead here. We hear more and enough and more about sexism in the industry, right? Don't you think somewhere it's a certain disservice that there's also women who are pulling down other women who probably have a legacy name and who are not fighting the issue the way they should be?
See, that's got nothing to do with gender. That happens both ways, okay? It's not like they are pulling down a woman because they are a woman. It's probably their instinct to pull down people. That's how they live. Yeah, I mean, like, see, now I would rather look at it like a glass half full. Because good and bad exists in both the genders, okay? You cannot just say that only women are the ones who are pulling down. Probably men, there are men who are conspiring in a different way to pull down other men. It happens both ways. But let's look at the glass half full. There still are women who would want to do whatever they can in their capacity to push, you know. Otherwise, we just keep on cribbing about this side and not look at the positives and promote that. So let's just look at the positive side of it, because there are women who help as well.
So my name is Henry Peter. I am from Janakpuri, CU and New Delhi.
Okay.
So, ki baat hai. So first and foremost, I would like to congratulate you. And as we are having the conversation session with the topic women in lead, and you are the right person as you are leading. And
I thought it was your married date,
so I request all the audience to clap for your parents especially.
Okay, I want
to clap. For your daddy and mommy, you gave...
आपको उन्होंने तो नहीं भेजा?
क्योंकि मैं जानता हूँ कैसा struggle होता है और आप कैसे ऊपर तक आए हैं. So you can change everything in your family other than your name.
I don't want to change my name. Who said that?
So my question. Future, you may get daughter. What name would you like to suggest?
ये आपने बहुत personal question पूछी.
तो बेटी का नाम क्या देना चाहते
हैं? अरे आपको क्यों बताऊँ अभी मैं बेटी को. क्या ये क्या बात हो गई? बेटी का नाम बताओ. तुमने रख लिया तो मेरी बेटी का नाम फिर बहुत common नहीं रहेगा. Common हो जाएगा तो फिर ऐसे कहेंगे. ऐसे ना personal question मत पूछो यार. ऐसा तो मतलब आप मुझे मतलब awkward कर रहे हो.
So thanks for your movie Bullseye, which we enjoyed more.
Thank you.
And thank you so much.
Take the last two questions.
Last two beautiful roles in your movie.
Thank you.
Yeah, those strong characters. I'm a big fan of yours.
Thank you.
I just wanted to ask, like, where do you see yourself after 10 years? I mean, this industry. Because you said if there is a fun factor, then only you will be doing the movie.
Yes.
But if at all that exists, where do you see yourself after 10 years?
In the film industry, you're asking.
Yeah.
So that's what. If I'm hoping I keep getting interesting films and roles, no matter how old I get, depending upon whatever age I'm in, I get roles accordingly. And some good interesting parts to play, which makes me feel excited every day to get up in the morning and go to work. Otherwise, I'm not doing it. So I'm hoping 10 years from now, I still keep doing that. Because I remember, now it's been, I think it's a 9th year for me in the film industry. And 8-9 years back in my interviews, when people used to ask me, where do you see yourself 5-6 years from now? I was always fed with this information and told that an actress's shelf life is only for 5-6 years at the prime, and then you start declining. So I accepted it because I knew no better. So in those interviews I used to say, after 5-6 years, okay, maybe I will settle down, I will, you know, have a family, I will do something else.
So movie direction is not in your card.
No. Movie direction? No, that's a very difficult job. Huh? Let me just tell you.
Okay.
I think directors, I don't know how they handle that pressure from producer's side and actor's side. That's one job I'm not touching, to be a director. That's too much for me to fathom. I can't do that. Please don't expect me to do that.
He's doing the good work for your
time.
Excuse me. Last question. Excuse me, ma'am.
Wo answer pura nahi hua tha. Sir, aapke to bade question hai. Aapke main baad mein baat karta
hoon. Excuse me, ma'am.
Aap dono ke le lenge, theek hai?
नहीं, मैं वो पिछली वाली मैडम का बोल रहा हूँ. 10 साल में कहाँ देखती हूँ वो पूरा.
10 साल में सर आपका वो आंसर, आपको जो सुनना है वो बाद में बता दूंगी मैं. ठीक है, उन्होंने जो सुना था उन्होंने सुन लिया.
मैम, माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गुड आफ्टरनून.
दैट इज सो क्वेश्चन.
सो माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट, इफ यू गेट चांस टू प्ले सुपर हीरो रोल इन एनी क्रिश सीरीज बाय राकेश रोशन,
एनी क्रिश सीरीज,
या विल यू प्ले?
मैं मना क्यों कहूंगी यार, ये कैसा क्वेश्चन हुआ? ये मतलब तुम्हें राकेश रोशन जी क्यों नहीं भेजा गई? तुम बताओ, भेजा है तो मेरा आंसर हाँ है. बोल दो उनको जाके, बोल दो. हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल करूंगी मैं यार, ये कैसा क्वेश्चन हुआ? जरूर करूंगी. हाँ सर, आप बताइए. माइक दो बेचारे को प्लीज.
राहुल मैम, you have been fabulous in acting so far.
Thank you.
No more questions from acting. When is your next stand-up coming?
आजकल बड़ा embarrassing हो गया है. लोग मेरे पास आते हैं, usually वो बोलते हैं this film that. आजकल तो मैम आपने क्या stand-up comedy करी है? अब अगली बारी कब आएंगे? So much so that my management has got a request for one stand-up comedy act from me. At some event, they want me to come as a stand-up comedian somewhere. I don't know if it's a good thing to me, for me to hear as an actor or no. I am not sure if this is a compliment or a compliment right now. अच्छी खासी मेरी acting की दुकान चल रही है, तो मुझे stand-up comedian बनाने में लगी हुआ यार. अभी ऐसे थोड़ा बहुत फंसा देती हूँ लोगों को, but ऐसे profession की तरह नहीं लिया. जिस दिन मेरी picture की ticket खरीदना बंद कर दोगे, उस दिन try कर लूँगी, ठीक है?
Hi ma'am,
hello.
Hi, I'm Akshana coming from IAVM Institute in Chennai. My question is, how do you feel about like a legend to act Amitabh Bachchan? It is a challenge to you?
अच्छा अभी मैं ना एक आंसर दे दूँ. I was telling her also, remember that आप सब मुझसे कोई मुझसे पूछेगा कैसा एक्सपीरियंस था अमिताभ बच्चन के साथ काम करने का, अक्षय कुमार के साथ काम करने का, वरुण के साथ काम करने का, विकी के साथ काम करने का. बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था, वेरी गुड एक्सपीरियंस. इवन इफ इट्स बैड आई विल नॉट टेल इट हियर. ओके सो प्लीज डोंट आस्क मी दिस क्वेश्चन बिकॉज आई एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम दिस क्राउड अ फिल्म you know, a film festival crowd to ask me better questions than experience of working with co-actors.
Hello, ma'am. Huh. Hello, ma'am. This is Ayushka. Ma'am.
Hello, ma'am. Huh.
It's great to see you, ma'am. I wanted to ask you, we've all come from a background or a childhood where all of us have been watching movies that are not so female-centric. And coming from that background, somewhere Bollywood shapes our childhood. So coming from that background, how did it inspire you to choose unconventional roles?
I think because I didn't see all those films while growing up. That's why. Because as I told you, in my school life, I did not see many of those films. And I've always been a child who, you know, this is a very cliche term, they use a rebellious. I'll tell you why. Because I always used to question my family a lot. Why not? You're supposed to do this. Why am I supposed to do this? This is wrong. Why is it wrong? So I always used to ask, so when I used to see these films after going to college and all, why is always hero supposed to be doing the righteous thing and the woman is always supposed to be seeking help from the man every time, in every film. And she's supposed to be the moral support or emotional support all the time. Is it reflecting a society where, you know, in my house I see my mother doing that for my father, always in the shadow, always supporting him morally, and my dad is the bread earner of the family. Is it reflecting that? But then it has people like me also who are like, wait, why should I just stand behind? Why can't I lead? So I was like, okay, if it has people like me and my mother both, I think it's time for people like me also to come up and be the hero of our stories. And that's when the change will happen, you know. We all, itne saalon se chalta aa raha hai yaar, ye ek overnight mein nahi change hota. So you need to give it time. You need to slowly let it seep in, because it's a very new trend for suddenly women to take the center stage and say, I am the hero of my film. I'm the one who's going to be doing the job or the right or wrong, whatever, in the film. It's going to take time for people to digest it. So let's not just like jump into saying nahi ho raha hai, nahi ho raha. Let's give it time, and then sooner or later it will happen. Okay? Thank you guys. Thank you. It was wonderful, wonderful. The hall is still full. I'm very surprised. Thank you.